Welcome to Love and Forever Evolving. Welcome, Sagittarius. Welcome, welcome. I hope all is well. And welcome as well to my earth angels. I appreciate you all. Thank you all so much for your love and support. And welcome to the ones that are new here, Sagittarius. It is a pleasure to have you. Definitely, if today's reading resonates for you, loves, don't forget to subscribe. We would love to have you here as well, a part of our family. And be sure to share the message if you feel like it's going to help enlighten someone else or help them along their journey. All right, so no further ado, archers, we're going to go ahead and dive in, see what's going on, as always, in the month of September right now when it comes to your love life, all right? So definitely take care of what resonates for you, Sagittarius, and leave here on the table what does not. Sagittarius, you all right? Some of y'all might be moving a little bit too fast. You might need to slow down, okay? I'm picking the energy up already just with how the cards are going right now. Some of y'all, you may feel like you're all over the place, or someone around you could be all over the place, okay? Take your time, all right, Sagittarius? Be patient. Yeah, someone is eager, okay? These cards are really trying to jump out. We got the Eight of Pentacles here, Taurus, Capricorn, and Virgo energy here. So some of y'all, you're just mainly more focused on whatever this is that you're creating or wanting to put together or accomplish yourself. I feel like some of y'all are going back to the drawing board here. Some of y'all are trying to figure some things out. Definitely working on your craft or whatever this is, Sagittarius, that you are trying to or wanting to manifest for yourself. Okay? Let's see. Let's see if any Sagittarius is out here focused on love. I see you focused on the things that you love to do or want to do, you know, but finding maybe more ways to set your foundation for yourself. Yeah, there is definitely a love offer. You see the cards jumping out like that? Listen, I feel like this is more so somebody around you, because this card came out just fine. I pay attention to everything, and which is showing up to be your energy right now. You're in your earth element. You're working, putting in some time. You're definitely investing in your time in some type of opportunity here that's bringing in more financial opportunities for you, Sagittarius. And someone is, they're having a difficult time focusing in on their physical aspect of life, their and their emotions with you right now. So this could be someone that wants to come towards you and apologize to you, Sagittarius. Someone definitely wants to come towards you in an emotional way or space with expressing themselves towards you right now. Let's get into the energy and see why. What do we have for Sagittarius, Pisces? What do we have for the archers? What do we got for the earth angels? Clarify the Knight of Cups, please. Who is this person coming in with this offer here? This could also be a water sign for some of you all, Sagittarius. This could be a Cancer or a Pisces. Look at these cards. We got the Tower here. And then we have the Death card. Okay, we're going to see how this is going. For some of y'all, what I'm picking up here intuitively is that someone is wanting to come towards you with an apology. Obviously, in my eyes, because with the Death card being in reverse, that's indicating that someone is obviously not wanting to put something to an end. When the card is in the upright, it's going through a transformation, letting something go, ending some type of cycle or pattern, okay? But it's in reverse. So someone doesn't want to end this pattern or this cycle or this relationship or whatever ship this is, okay? The Tower here. And on top of that, this person was trying to avoid their own tower or their own way or cause of destruction and not wanting to change, okay? Because the Tower brings in changes. Something has to be teared down in order for something to be rebuilt. Something has to die before something can be reborn or transformed. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like whoever this person here was, they could have been their ego a lot, Sagittarius. They could have been very one-sided in this relationship or this connection. And I feel like because most of you all, you decide to focus on your physical perspective of yourself. Rather, that's your physical health, your physical mindset, your physical mental And some of y'all are getting your finances in your career right now. You could be using to utilize that energy and transmuting it into your more things that you feel like basic or more important to you right now than allowing yourself to get lost in this type of energy or environment. You know, I feel like some of y'all have already been there. You already understand how that feels. So you are making sure, and you're not allowing yourself to get back in that space with this person before. This is clearly giving me someone from your past. Unfortunately, Sagittarius is okay, but this is definitely allowing you to see that how far you've come. You know, you, I'm sure, was in this space. We've all been in this space before that we didn't like the way that it made us feel, right? And I love this because you've grown. You have evolved over time here, Sagittarius, spiritually, mentally, and emotionally here, that you are now knowing how to utilize or transmute that energy in other spaces and areas that you could know that could use that time. You know, knowing how to balance your emotions here. Okay, so let's see, why is all this going on with this energy? Again, we got heavy water energy here. Some of y'all, this person could have high water placements in their chart as a Cancer, a Pisces, a Scorpio. Look, all these person cards is coming up in reverse. We got the Emperor. Some of y'all, this could have been an Aries here with the Emperor, or this could have been Aquarius. The Emperor in reverse is a space of an energy, of a masculine energy that's not able to manifest or not able to think clearly, operate clearly, be a leader. They're not even able to be a leader. The Emperor represents a boss energy. You know, I'm hearing Libra. Some of y'all, this person could be a Libra. Yeah, and I feel like this conflicts you, Sagittarius. You're very conflicted by this person because of the situation and how I feel like they allowed themselves to either let themselves go, you know, and someone wasn't thinking clearly here, Sagittarius, with their choices here. And now they're starting to see all of this blow up in their face. The Queen of Wands, yeah, this person is very attracted to you. And they've always thought highly of you. They've always, you know, in the back of their mind, show respect to you. But it's a space now where that respect is not even given, you know. Clarify the Queen of Wands. And there's a lot of competition around you, Sagittarius. Unfortunately, people feel that way about you. You really imitate you. People are scared because of your success and because of your looks and because of the way you carry yourself, Sagittarius. This also caused other people to be conflicted here. We got the Two of Swords here. Libra energy, also Gemini and Aquarius energy there. Yeah, the Queen of Cups here. Some of y'all, this could be a third party situation here with two different queens, okay? This could be a situation where this person, this Emperor, could have been involved with this Queen of Cups and this Queen of Wands. Sagittarius here, and this is something that you all are maybe contemplating, or this Queen of Cups is contemplating with making a decision here. So it looks like there's a third party here and everyone is aware or involved here. Or I feel like also something got exposed here with that Tower coming out in reverse. Yeah, the Strength card. Something that you had to overcome here, Sagittarius. Leo energy. Some of y'all, this person could be a Leo. Yeah, we have the Sun card at the bottom of the deck. At the end of the day, everything worked out in your favor, Sagittarius. Everything worked out here in your favor, as it should, because again, you didn't entertain this person or even the energies that they brought behind them to this table. You chose to do better for yourself, for your life, for your health, for your mental, for your spirit, and just overall for you, Sagittarius. You've learned from this experience here. You have several major arcana cards that are coming out in the upright for you. So a lot of good opportunities are coming towards you because of your choices, and your choices are going to reward you in this situation here. Okay. Wow, Sagittarius. So let's see how this person feels as we close out your reading. Let's see what they want to say. You are my peace of mind, Sagittarius. Wow, somebody understands. Somebody understands this assignment here. Please come back home. Yeah, and it's like now that you decide again to focus on new invaders for yourselves, others are bothered with that. Other are, you know, feel some type of way because you now understand, you know the truth. You know the elephant in the room here. We got bad health. Wow. Some people's health is not in the good, best shape right now because of this situation. I feel like it's whoever this energy here over here is, because like I mentioned, this emperor is not able to be the emperor right now. They can't tell you anything or give you any type of advice because they're not taking their own advice. They're not wanting to end situations that they know that they should have ended with people, places, or certain circumstances a long time ago. So they even try to avoid their own karma. You know what I'm saying? And now it's causing their health to be bad. They're yearning for you to come back, you know, looking for that peace of mind that you can no longer give them. The peace of mind that they're looking for is within themselves. You tried to help them, to lead them to the water, but you can't make them drink it. You can, you know, you can only do so much. You can show a person everything that they can have at the palm of their hands, but it's up to them to want to take that advice, or, you know, you had to do it. And their problem is they want to get a shortcut. Mm-hmm. They thought that they was going to get a shortcut. This shit going to full circle your ass. And you're going to be positioned to start all over again. And it's going to be up to you on how you want to start moving forward. I want every part of you by my side. Wow, Sagittarius. What a very enlightening reading here today. Okay, I will not put you in this again. Yeah, I'm just randomly pulling cards out here just to see what will come out. Ashe. Okay, that is confirmation. Keep doing what you're doing, Sagittarius. Your angels, your spirit teams are here guiding you. All right. Wow, archers. I'm going to leave this portion of the reading here. Earth angels, thank you so much, Sagittarius, for your love and support. Again, like, subscribe if this is your first time here. Definitely go check out all the other Sagittarius readings that I do post on this channel and any other placements that you have in your chart. All right. Definitely within Sagittarius. Okay. Definitely go check those messages out for yourself as well. I love you. And I definitely wish you all love, peace, and blessings, honey. Mwah. Bye-bye.